You don't want to talk to me this morning. Come on. You need to get delivered from your deadlines. I know you want to accomplish it by a certain amount of time, but how are you prioritizing your time with God? Is God as important to you as your 9 to 5? Because if you're too busy to have time for God, then you're just too doggone busy, honey. Everybody, and welcome back to Siobhan Sheree TV, and I'm back again with another video. I also want to say, if this is your first time ever watching my channel, ever knowing who I am, ever clicking on my face, I want to say, hey, hello, how are you? My name is Siobhan Sheree. I'm a preacher, a worship leader, and a prophetess, and I absolutely love Jesus with my whole entire heart. We are the CC community. We cover all things faith and fashion, Bible and beauty, being snatched and saved. If that's something that's kind of your cup of tea, that's not kind of up your alley, if that's kind of your zhuzh, okay? Honey, what are you doing? What are you waiting for? Come on and subscribe, okay? Don't be shady, all right? Some of y'all are really shady. I'm not even gonna lie. I mean, 63% of you guys watch my videos and you're not subscribed. Girl, why are you not? We're gonna wait, okay? You subscribe? You hit it? All right, great. Bring it in. Come on, you know what time it is. It's time for a group hug. Oh, yes. Socially distancing, emotionally available. Today's topic, we're going to be talking about the balancing act, okay? You can't have any kind of balance in your life if you're burned out. Oh, you didn't think I was coming in hot like that. Baby, how can you be balanced in your work life, but you get burned out? How can you be balanced in ministry, but you get burned out? How can you have a marriage that thrives and that is prosperous and that is full of love and compassion? How can you do that if you get burned out? How can you do that? How can you do friendship? How can you do relationship? How can you do career? How can you do any of these things if you get burned out? So today we're going to be tackling the enemy of balance, which is burnout. So let's talk about this. I'm going to be reading from Luke chapter 10. The 38th verse. It's good to have a physical Bible, you know, because if you have your phone, somebody could text you, hey, big head, and the next you know, you're distracted. Or you get a notification on your phone and you go through this TikTok rabbit hole. Baby, don't do that. Come on, I need you to focus. Luke chapter 10, and we're gonna start at the 38th verse. Okay. Here it goes. Now it came to pass as they went that he entered into a certain village, and a certain woman named Martha received him into her house. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. I'm gonna get back there, okay? But Martha was encumbered about much serving. And it came to him, and Jesus said, Lord, dost thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Bid her, tell her, snatch her edges, let her know, okay, that she gotta come over here and come help me. Oh, I can't wait to preach that. Here we go, and it gets better. And Jesus answered and said unto her, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled. Honey, why are you so pressed? Relax, Martha, relax. Listen, you're troubled about many things, but one thing is needful, and Mary has chosen that good part, which shall not be taken away from her. Come on, I want you to type in the comment section. It ain't about to be taken away from me. I don't know what your it is, but listen, my family is not about to be taken away from me. My career is not about to be taken away from me. My relationship with God is not about to be taken away from me. The relationships that are soon to come, my marriage is not gonna be taken away from me. I chose the good part. I chose to sit at Jesus' feet. I could have done anything else, but I chose to click on Siobhan Sheree TV and get a word from the Lord. It's not gonna be taken away from me. Ooh, child, I feel like preaching. Come on. All right, so in the text, we find Jesus, and he is doing what he does best. I mean, he is saving souls. He is snatching edges. He is over here casting out demons. He's over here healing blind eyes. He's over here raising the dead. He's over here being the gangster that he is. He's being the supreme, ultimate, amazing, charismatic leader that anybody has ever seen. So much, in fact, that we're still talking about him. Come on, somebody. So Jesus is doing what he does best, and he decides, you know what? I'm gonna go into this village, and there's a girl named Martha that receives him. All right, I didn't put this in my notes, but it's the beautiful part that she actually received him. And so many of us, Jesus is knocking at our door, but will we receive him? Will we even allow him to come into our heart? Will we even allow him to come into our homes? Will we even allow him access to our relationships? Come on, somebody. Will we even allow him? Will we even receive him? Will we even give him permission to come into our lives and to change some things? Will we give him permission to step into our house and to tell us, you know what, this is out of order. You know what, you need to really get rid of this addiction. You know what, you really need to go and take care of this relationship. You know, you really need to be investing into your friendships. How many of us, when Jesus is knocking on our door, will we even receive him? That's a whole word right there. Come on. We have Martha and then we have Mary. So I want to walk you through some of the character analysis of who these women are. Luke chapter 8, verse 1, it says, "And it came to pass afterward that he went throughout every city and village, preaching and showing the glad tidings of the kingdom of God. And the 12 were with him. And a certain woman which had been healed of evil spirits and infirmities, Mary called Magdalene, out of whom went 7 devils." Listen to me, okay? Mary is beautiful. She's lustful. She is a seductress. She's the kind of woman that you call when you want to have a good time. Come on. Mary is over here. She got an OnlyFans. Y'all don't want to talk to me today. Mary is out here being a hot girl, throwing it back for a thirst trap. You understand what I'm saying? And the Bible says that the first encounter Jesus ever had with her, he cast out 7 devils that were in her. Can you imagine? The first interaction you ever have with Jesus, he's over here telling you, you know what? That greed gotta come out. That gluttony spirit, okay, I know you said you was only gonna have like 1 slice of pizza, but you ate the whole box, okay? That gluttony spirit, it gotta come out. That insecurity, gotta come out. That comparison, gotta come out. Can you imagine the first time you ever encountered Jesus, he is snatching your edges. He is literally coming for you, reading you for filth. Can you imagine that? She is the woman that she took a year's worth of her earnings. Now, you got to remember what her job was. We like to pretty up the story, but there's nothing pretty about this story at all. There's nothing pretty about prostitution. There's nothing pretty about human trafficking, although those things are still rampant in the earth. Here we have a woman who has a questionable past, right? And how many of us, we got a questionable past. Took all of her earnings from being a stripper. She took all of her earnings from being a prostitute. She took all of her earnings from being an Instagram baddie. She took all those earnings that she got from all those affiliate links. Y'all won't talk. Come on. She took all those earnings that she got from endorsing Savage Fenty. She broke that alabaster box and she poured it at Jesus's feet and she cried. She cried so much enough to where she could wash Jesus's feet with her tears. And then she took her hair and she wiped Jesus's feet with her hair. Now, I know one thing. I know those who watch my channel, I know you ain't about to mess up your lace front trying to wipe some tears, just trying to wipe somebody's feet. You gonna take your lace and put that on feet? Come on, some of y'all don't even play with feet like that. Come on, you know, Jesus been journeying. You don't know if his feet smell like corn chips or what? You don't know what his feet smelled like. She put herself in this place of submission. She put herself in this place of humility. She put herself in this place of servitude that she wasn't worried about who was around. She wasn't worried about if people were gonna judge her. She wasn't worried about her past. She wasn't worried about her mistakes, but she came to Jesus humbly. She came to Jesus with a spirit of submission. She came to Jesus ready and willing to be renewed. Mary is an important figure here. Then we have Martha. She has a bad rep for being worried, for being anxious, for being fearful, for being fretful, for being stressed, for being overwhelmed, for being worried all the time. But Martha was cumbered about much serving and came to him and said, "Lord, dost thou not care that my sister has left me to serve alone?" Like, can you just imagine? One sister is sitting at the feet of Jesus and the other sister is in the kitchen and she's over here slamming dishes. Come on, you know how we do, ladies, and mopping the floor and splashing water everywhere. Imagine, you know, just her being petty. I don't know about you. I'm petty, so I see the Bible through the lens of a petty person, okay? I could be a little petty sometimes. As she's putting together the fried chicken and the red beans and the collard greens and the cornbread, as she's doing all these things, she says, "You know what? I done had it up there." She wipes her hands off of her apron and she says, "Jesus, don't you care? Don't you care? Don't you see Don't you see how I'm working? Don't you see how much I'm pouring out? God, don't you see? Don't you see how much I'm putting blood, sweat, and tears into this? Don't you see how every time I put my hand to something, it's failing? God, don't you see? Don't you see how my child is acting crazy? God, don't you see how my marriage is falling apart? God, don't you see how I'm still unemployed? God, don't you see it? Don't you see how I'm behind on my bills? God, don't you see it? Don't you see me trying to juggle all these different things? Don't you see me trying to wear all these different hats? Don't you see me trying to be a mom and be a wife and be a business owner? God, don't you see it? Don't you see me every time I'm writing out these business plans? God, don't you see me? And why are you not coming near to me? God, why aren't you focusing on the things that I'm doing? God, Lord, don't you care? I want you to catch that. Jesus never said that he didn't care. Martha cared about things that Jesus didn't care about. And this is classically how we get burned out, because we start caring about things that God didn't care about. Some of y'all need to get delivered from your deadlines. You don't want to talk to me this morning. Come on. You need to get delivered from your deadlines. I know you want to accomplish it by a certain amount of time, but how are you prioritizing your time with God? Is God as important to you as your 9 to 5? Because if you're too busy to have time for God, then you're just too doggone busy, honey. Okay, I'm telling you right now, Jesus cares about things that sometimes we may not even care about. You may be caring about your career, but God is really caring about you getting your pride in check. You may be caring about having an hourglass figure, but God really wants you to care about having self-esteem again. You may be caring about launching the business at the specific time, but God must be really worried about how you manage your own finances. See, there are things sometimes where we care about things that Jesus don't care about. How many times do we put words in God's mouth? Did you know that the devil can lie to you and tell you that God doesn't care, that God doesn't see, that God doesn't feel your pain? That came to come against the lie of the enemy trying to tell you that you're not anointed when you are. I came to come against the lie of the enemy trying to tell you that God doesn't care, that God doesn't see, that God doesn't feel your pain, that God is far from you, that God is not with you, that God is not for you. I came to come against that lie in the name of Jesus, because he is for you and he's never against you. That you're the head and not the tail. You're above only and not beneath. You are a royal priesthood. You need to understand that you are a peculiar people, that you are like a city set on a hill. You need to understand, baby, that when you walk into the room, atmospheres change. You need to understand that when you start to speak, chains start breaking off of people. You need to understand that you are not like the regular. You are not like the average. You are not just like anybody else. You are not meant to fit in or to blend in. You are not meant to be like everybody else. I need you to understand that God cares. He cares about every single detail of your life. That's what I put my channel on. Man, I'm telling you something right now. I'm hearing so many testimonies about people who are struggling with their skin. And because God cares about every detail, he's clearing people's skin up. Man, I put out a video about God growing people's hair back. And I got so many praise reports of God growing people's hair back. Come on, somebody. God cares about every single detail of your life. But how many times are we putting words in Jesus' mouth saying that he doesn't care? God cares. He cares about every single detail of your life, okay? Without balance, you get burned out. And whenever you get burned out, then you start to blame people. Well, God, I would spend more time with you, but it's these children that you gave me. I would spend more time with you, but I'm out here trying to make this money. God, I would spend more time with you, but I'm lonely and I'm single right now. God, it's not me, it's that woman you gave me. Come on, Adam. She says, tell Mary to come help me. Stop what you're doing, Jesus. I see y'all laughing and kikiing over there in that corner, but Jesus, I need you to stop what you're doing with Mary. Tell her to help me. I need somebody else. I don't have the resources. I don't have the people. I don't have the help. I don't have the time. I don't have the energy. Instead of asking for a human to help you, somebody who is frail, somebody who is inconsistent, somebody who needs God just as desperately as you do. Instead of asking for the people, you need to start sitting at the feet of Jesus. You need to start fasting and praying. You need to start asking the Lord for direction and for clarity and hindsight and insight and foresight. You need to be asking the Lord. You need to be sitting at his feet. Instead of dragging people into your mess, why don't you take your mess to Jesus? Instead of dragging other people into your problems, why don't you take your problems to Jesus? Some of y'all, the reason why your relationships aren't working out is because you want to run your mouth about your relationship to everybody. Some things are meant to be private. So don't blame people for spreading all of your business if you're the one who's telling it. Baby, instead of spreading your mess, take your mess to Jesus. It says here, Jesus says, you are stressed about too much serving. The problem is not the problem, Martha, okay? You're saying the problem is Mary, but the problem is your anxiety. You're saying that the problem is all the work that you have to do. The problem is that you distrust others. You're saying that you're under too much pressure, but really its problem is you won't give all of your pressures to God. Jesus says, the one thing that you need to do, you're not doing. Mary is doing this. She's sitting at my feet with Jesus. She's renewing her mind by reading this word. She's praying. She's getting instruction. She's getting clarity. She's getting insight. And she's not trying to balance motherhood alone. She's not trying to balance career and finance and marriage and her family and all these different things. She decided to stop every distraction and to sit at Jesus' feet. So my question to you today is, and I'm about to wrap up. So are you Martha? Are you Mary? Are you going to be worried? Are you going to be anxious forever? Are you going to get burned out? Are you going to choose today? I'm going to be Mary. I'm just going to sit. I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait to hear what God is going to say to me. I'm going to keep watching some prophetic words. I'm going to keep praying. I'm going to keep fasting. And I'm going to stay in the place that God wants me to be. So I'm encouraging today, if you really want to stop getting burned out, you've got to get balance. I love you guys. That's all I got for today. But until the next time, remember that we do every single thing to glorify God. So remember to stay snatched and saved. Bye.